for no other word that really fits partly of what I'm trying to say this morning, I'm using reverse psychology. Kind of, a little bit, maybe, I'm not sure. Reverse psychology. Hallelujah. Because what I really want to talk about here this morning is to be absolutely, to be as possessive with God as possible. To be as greedy for yourself as possible. We talk so much in the church today, we talk so much in the kingdom of heaven about being selfless. Selfless. And I want to talk this morning about how to be absolutely the most selfish. That's why this is not for you, it is for me. Because I believe in being the most selfish possible. Turn your Bibles, please, to Mark chapter 9. You see, folks, I want to be first in everything. I want first in everything. I desire to be first. Again, this is not for you, this is between me and God. God, I desire to be first. I want to be first. It is a burning within me that at times drives me crazy, that I want to be first. I desire to be first when it comes time to hand out awards. I want to be first. I want to be first when it's time for recognition. I want to be the first one to be recognized. I burn with a desire to be first when it is time to receive honors. I want first. And I want first when we are praised for excellence. I want to be first. When it is required to be the strongest, fastest, toughest, most powerful in the kingdom of God, I want to be first. Hear that, Lord? Yes. This is the desire of my heart that I be first. I want to be first. Not second. Not third. Not fourth. But God, the desire of my heart is to be first. I want to be first. Mark chapter 9. Beginning with verse 33. And he came to Capernaum. And being in the house, he asked, "What was it that ye disputed among yourselves by the way?" But they held their peace, for by the way they had disputed among themselves who should be the greatest. And he sat down and called the 12 and saith unto them, "If any man desire to be first," stop right there. Any man desire to be first. Timothy, I cannot. There are no words in my vocabulary that could challenge you, that could probe you, that could motivate you, that could inspire you. Those are just the best words. There's no other words that I can find than to challenge you to absolutely desire first. Now, before I go on, let us understand this reality. From here on, what I'm going to talk about, a high-minded, stiff-necked, proudful, boastful, haughty, narcissistic individual could never get to. Could never get there. Where we're going to go from here. Could never get there. And see, that's where we make the mistake as Christian people. We think
think that if we're desirous to be first, that somehow we're too proudful, that somehow we're too heady, that somehow we're too naughty, that somehow we're too boastful. I just got through preaching to nearly 500 young people this last summer and challenged them to the very best that I could be to run their race to win first prize. There's no second place. There's no awards for participation. There's only first place. When Paul gave that analogy, as he watched the Greeks in the Olympics and as athletes were training, the reality was this: in many instances, if a city or a community thought they had an athlete that had potential and should win the race or win the wrestling match or win the throwing or the tossing or whatever it might be, and if they did not win, if they came in second place, in many instances, their consequence was death. There was no second place. There was no second place. We read this morning in Sunday school that to each person is given a certain measure of faith, a measure of meat, a measure of talent. And if they invest that talent, they invest that faith into the kingdom of God, then they will reap a harvest and they will be rewarded by the master. But if an individual denies and does not invest that talent, whatever they were given, into the kingdom of God, not only will it be taken from them, what they did get, but they will be cast into outer darkness where there is weeping and gnashing of teeth. It will be taken from them. If you were to take an athlete in any sport, any event, male or female, it doesn't matter, and this individual have the ability that if they just tried their best, tried their hardest, that without question they would win first place. I mean, there's no question. They're the fastest, they're the strongest, they're whatever. They can throw the furthest. Without question. If they just tried their best, they would win, no question. And if that individual athlete chose of their own free will to not try their best, and that second place or third place, or let my friend win, or take fourth place, they just didn't want to try their best. That talent, if not taken from them, should be extracted from them and given to one lesser that they might be better. It is, in the kingdom of God, it is absolutely inexcusable to suffice ourselves with anything but first and best. Inexcusable. Now, there are seasons and times. There are seasons and times where you sow, where you plow in tears, and there's times and seasons where it may seem like all efforts are just futile. Nobody cares. God doesn't care. He doesn't hear. I try. The harder I try, the worse I do. I understand that completely. But I also know that that season is going to come to an end if we're faithful. Say amen. That season is going to come to an end if we're faithful. And then there will come a season where we will reap in joy and in laughter and in prosperity, because God is always faithful to reward the faithful. Say amen. And this morning, there's no way, so please understand, there's no way that a hot-headed, high-minded, stiff-necked, proudful, egotistical, boastful, narcissistic person could ever do what we're talking about doing. And I'm going to get to it in just a moment. So that's already cast aside. So then where does that leave us? That leaves us in this scripture where Jesus said, if any man desire to be first, if means this, if means freedom of choice. It means I have the choice to choose. I have the choice to be first, or I can choose to be second or third or fourth, or I can just choose to fit in. Or I can choose to stand up and to stand out and declare something on behalf of the kingdom of God and the kingdom of heaven, make a personal faith statement to the world, and stand for something. It's easy to not stand for anything. You just fit in with everybody else. You just do what everybody else is doing. You go 15 miles an hour under the speed limit, you just get in line and you just follow the person nose to nose who was there in front of you. You don't stand for anything. There's countries, there's people who stand for nothing. If any man desire to be first, if any man desire to be first, let's continue to read it. If any man desire to be first, the same shall be last of all and servant of all.
Yes.
I'm here to tell you something, folks. A high-minded, haughty, proudful, stiff-necked, boastful, narcissistic person could never in the world. I'm a social scientist. I have great education and experience in the world of psychology. And there's no way, 100% no way, without some sort of life-changing experience, that a high-minded, haughty, stiff-necked, egotistical, boastful, narcissistic could ever make themselves last, put themselves last, and become servant of all. Never. It is an absolute impossibility for that to take place. So here's the kicker. Listen to what I'm going to say one more time. Lord, I desire to be first. When it comes time to hand out awards, I want to be first. When it comes time for recognition, I want to be first. When it's time to receive honors, I want to be first. When we are praised for excellence, I want to be first. When it is required to be the strongest, fastest, toughest, most powerful in the kingdom of heaven, I want to be first. And when it comes time to be chosen, I want to be chosen first. When it comes time to be chosen, I want to be chosen first. And I desire to be first. And when it comes time to be chosen as a servant of all, I want to be chosen first. Now, the person is a narcissistic, high-minded, heady, proudful, boastful moron. He could never say to himself, Lord, when it comes time to be a servant, choose me first. He could never say, Lord, when it comes time to be last, choose me first. He could never, never, ever do that. So Christian people, let's lay down all the misnomers, let's lay down all the flags. God, this is between you and me. You hear what I'm saying today, and I'm saying choose me first. Choose me first to be servant of all. Choose me first to serve in the kingdom of God. Choose me first to serve the people. Set a plan within my life. Set a strategy within my life. Send me to a place. Send me to an area. Send me in my mind, my heart, my soul, where that I might be chosen first to serve all. Therein, knowing you as my Lord and Savior, that's being one with God. Let me give you just a few examples of the past. Because I believe we have to have strategy to be servant of all. I don't think it's a matter of just God, well, whatever it is. You know, if you want me to bring it by, if you want me to go there, bring it by, let me know, tell me willy-nilly. No. I think we have to on purpose say, choose me to serve. I want to serve. I want to serve. I want to be a servant.